question says the function f and g are defined for x as an element of real number and fx equals 2x plus 1 and gx equals x square minus 2. Find and simplify the expression fgx and gfx. So fgx means that in f we have to substitute the function gx, which would give us 2 times x square minus 2 plus 1. So that gives 2x square minus 4 plus 1. So 2x square minus 3. Next, we need to find gfx. So we have to substitute f in gx. So in G, we have to substitute fx, which is 2x plus 1. This would be 2x plus 1 whole square minus 2, which gives 4x square plus 4x plus 1 minus 2. So 4x square plus 4x minus 1. Next is part two, which is hence find the value of A for which FGA is equals to GFA. So we already have FGX and we have GFX. So all we need to do is replace the X with A and equate the two equations. So 2a square minus 3 is equals to 4a square plus 4a minus 1. Now simplify this quadratic equation, 2a square plus 4a plus 2. I'm going to take 2 common. And divide it with the 0 on the other side. So a square plus 2a plus 1. Now you can do middle term breaking here. And or I'm just going to use the trigonometric identity because I see this as a square plus 2ab plus b square. So it will be a plus 1 whole square. You could also do middle term breaking and get the same result. Now this gives us a plus 1. A plus 1 equals 0. So A is equals to negative 1 and A is equals to negative 1. So A is equals to negative 1 is our answer. Next up is part 3, which is find the value of B where B and A are not equal and F GB is equals to B. Now GB would be X square, sorry, b square minus 2 is equals to b. This also gets us the quadratic equation b square minus b minus 2 is equals to 0. Solve this. B square, I'm going to do middle term breaking, minus 2b plus b minus 2 is equals to 0. B common b minus 2 plus 1 common b minus 2. So b minus 2, b minus b plus 1 is equals to 0. So we're getting two answers. B is equals to 2 and b is equals to negative 1. However, the question said that b cannot be equals to a. And A came out to be negative 1. So this one has to be ignored because B cannot be equals to A. Ignored because B is not equals to A. And this is the only answer. Okay. Next up is find and simplify the expression for F inverse GX. So let's do part four here. So in F inverse, we have to substitute gx, which is x square minus 2. But first, we'll have to find F inverse of x. I am going to do that in one step. First, it's going to be y is equals to 2x plus 1. But in the end, we have to replace y with x. So I'm going to write x right away, x minus 1 upon 2. We've already done this in O levels. Okay, so this is F inverse. Now in it, we have to substitute x square minus 2. So x square minus 2 minus 1 upon 2, which gives x square minus 3 upon 2. Okay. Last part is part 5, which is function h is defined by hx equals x square minus 2, and its domain is less than equals to 0. Find an expression of h inverse of x. Okay, so y equals x square minus 2, y plus 2 equals x square, square root both sides, write plus minus here. So we have plus minus square root y plus 2 is equals to x. And when we write h inverse of x, we will only use the negative sign. So we're going to write negative x plus 2. Why do we only choose this negative sign? Because of this given domain. If the domain of hx is decreasing, then the range of h inverse of x needs to decrease as well. That's why there's a negative sign here.